The stock market is currently going through turbulent times, with many portfolios bleeding gains and others turning red. This cuts across sectors. Not even the biggest companies are spared. But something else happens when the market takes a dive. Many investors panic and sell their assets, even at a loss. But why? Why do people panic sell during a market crash? Why is Walmart packed on Black Fridays and people rush towards the exit when there is discount in the stock market? Why do people buy high and sell low? The truth is, it's natural to act this way. We are wired to seek safety at the slightest sight of danger, which is exactly what a market crash feels like. This behavior is explained by the cognitive bias called loss aversion, which is the tendency to prefer avoiding losses to acquiring equivalent gains. This, of course, is rooted in fear. However, no one makes money by buying high and selling low. So, a more important question is how we can manage this emotion better to stop panic selling and instead take the inherent opportunities in market corrections. So today, I'll be sharing with you 8 ways to avoid panic selling your stocks during a market downturn. 1. Avoid emotional investing. Investing in the stock market is risky, and it comes with a lot of volatility. To navigate this terrain successfully, you need a certain type of temperament, aka an investor mindset. As an investor, you almost always have to act contrary to your emotional state. Warren Buffett captures this in a great way. Be fearful when others are greedy, and greedy when others are fearful. Keeping your emotions in check will help you make more rational decisions irrespective of market conditions. 2. Always do your due diligence. I know you've heard this phrase many times and I've just added to the start. Sorry. It's because doing your due diligence is a fundamental part of investing. You shouldn't be investing in something you don't understand. That's gambling. Imagine how you will feel when the market crashes and your portfolio is full of meme stocks. So, if you don't want to panic sell your investment during a market downturn, be very careful with speculative investing. 3. Remember that the market has always bounced back. Historically, the market has always recovered. Note that I said the market and not any particular stock. Unfortunately, some stocks will not recover with the market. This makes the asset you invest in very crucial, so you can have peace of mind during a market crash. The stock market is like a roller coaster. Jumping out during a ride doesn't sound safe. 4. You've not lost money until you sell. Your current portfolio value is just a number on your investment app dashboard. It becomes real money once you press the sell button. Just like unrealized capital gains, you've not made a loss on your investment until you sell. Sometimes, the best thing to do as an investor is nothing. At the end of the day, your level of conviction in your investment will always influence your eventual decision. 5. See market crashes as opportunities. Imbibing an investor mindset will let you see a market crash as an opportunity to buy more quality stocks at a great discount, meaning a further increase in your potential return. You know how you always say, "I wish I bought Apple stock at X price"? Now you've got what you wanted. 6. Invest for the long term. What would you do when the market takes a dive and you have no money to fund a major expense? Your savings account is empty and you don't want to go into debt. This makes you highly likely to liquidate a portion of or your entire portfolio, even at a loss, to cover these costs. Like everyone else, you neither know how low prices will go nor how long the bear market will last. As a result, you just want to get your money out of the market as quickly as possible before the value of your portfolio reduces further. But you could have avoided being in this situation by not investing the money you need in the short term. 7. Stop checking your investment app every minute. investment tools have become quite accessible, making retail investors in particular more susceptible to erratic investment decisions. This is especially if you witness market volatility by the minute. Sometimes, the stock market can plunge considerably and make a dramatic recovery in the same trading session. Obsessively checking your investment accounts can make you panic sell during the earlier part of the session, thereby missing the rebound. 8. Stop watching market crash YouTube videos. Watching these videos has the same effect as the previous point, which is to sow the seeds of fear in your mind. Sadly, it's only natural to act on this emotion in a matter of time. Moreover, you should know that these videos are created mainly to get views. And what better way to do this than leverage bad news? Okay, let's summarize. Market crashes have been part of the stock market for decades, and no one knows when the next one will happen. What you can do as an investor is to prepare psychologically and financially, because this is the time when fortunes are made. Unsurprisingly, it's also the time when investor anxiety goes through the roof. However, you can manage your emotions better by doing all or some of the things I mentioned earlier. Investing is both rewarding and risky. As a result, it's always a balancing act. Your goal is to get the highest reward with the least amount of risk. I hope you make educated investment decisions during the current market downturn and in future. Hope you've learned something from this video. Don't forget to like it and subscribe to the channel for more. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.